I want to talk to you real quick. Three simple yet powerful principles. Now, get this now. Three simple yet powerful principles. And again, remember, what I teach is transcendent principles. So it's going to affect your uplift business. Once we get that going, it's going to affect your Shop Freemart business right now. It's going to affect your relationship. If you're married or in a relationship, it's going to affect your spiritual life. It's going to affect you in every, again, I teach transcendent principles that affect across many different arenas. And so again, and what I do is, and most of you don't understand this, but the hardest thing that I do is I take principles and break it down and boil stuff down to make it where it's as simple as possible so that you can grasp it, grab it, and run with it. And not only that, it could be duplicatable. See, 2 Timothy 2:2, the things which thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou unto faithful men who shall be able to teach others also. And so you've got to teach to teach to teach. Did you get that? Okay, coach, let me back up. I don't think they got that. See, you've got to teach people that will have the same ability to be able to teach other people. That's called duplication. See, again, it's great that I made Triple Crown, but that's not, and again, think about this, almost 68,000 members worldwide in 120 countries. There's about 490 now that have made ambassador. There's 60 that have made global. There's 19 that have made crown. Okay, but here's the thing. So being Triple Crown is okay, but that's not the real testimony. Here's the real testimonial. We've got 15 ambassadors, and 4 of them are global, and 1 is about to go crown. So again, my friend, what we're going to do by the grace of God is, and I was praying earlier this morning, is every week have at least an ambassador every week. And Coach says, calls it an ambassador factory, so an ambassador every week, and global once a month or more, and then a crown every quarter. So between all of us, now again, I'm the Breakthrough Bible Dream Team, and some of you will have your own sub-team names or whatever else, but that's what we endeavor to do, my friend. And here's the thing. If you grab hold of these three principles I give you this morning, I'm telling you, it's going to change every area of your life. Alrighty, so here we go. If you're ready, see, and you'll be able to see, by the way, the difference between people who are not successful, people who are successful, and people who are super successful. Okay, I didn't even have that plan to say, but maybe I'll break those 3 points down like that. So the people who are not successful, the people who are successful, and then the people who are super successful. And I don't know what category you want to be in, but I sure don't want to be in the one that's not, folks aren't successful, right? God never started anything for it not to succeed. Matter of fact, I get myself in trouble sometimes, but I said, look, why the churches call themselves nonprofit? God never started anything that was not for profit. Come on, somebody. So why are you going to let the government call you nonprofit? God never started anything. And it's not for profit. No, sir. The first command of the Bible before he said all the thou shalt nots, right? The Ten Commandments. No. The first command in Genesis 1:28, but God blessed them. By the way, the word blessed means empowered to prosper. God, listen, my friend, see, God will get you to do things that you feel like you can't do, but he knows more about you than you know about yourself. So the heart is deceitful, desperately wicked. Who can know it? I can't know my heart unless I go to the great God of the universe and ask him to reveal my heart to me. And by the way, my friend, that's why, again, if our heart condemns, God is greater than our heart. I said the other day, get out of your feelings and get into your favor. Come on, somebody, because your feelings will make you think it's Ichabod, that I can't do this. It's all No. That's your feelings, but that's not the favor, my friend. The favor is going to break you through. So watch this. So what differentiates? Because you got team members. You got folks that you care about. You got folks, and it seems like they're not successful, right? And then you got other folks, they are successful. But then you notice there's some who are super successful. Well, I break it down to these three things: if, because, or in spite of. That's it in a nutshell. If, because, or in spite of. Now, write those down. Remember, note takers are money makers, and the weakest ink is stronger than the strongest memory. But remember, it's not just the notes you take Dr. Breakthrough says it's the action you take on the notes you took. So note takers are money makers, but action takers are big money makers and big difference makers. So those who are not successful, they do things with this is based on if. Those who are successful, because. Those who are super successful is called in spite of. So let's tackle these real quick and wrap this up in a nice pretty bow and let you go. Number one, if that's called conditions. See the if crowd that usually aren't successful because they have conditions and they do things out of convenience. So write that down. It's conditions if. See, if this is working right, if the website's always working, if the website's always up, if everything I need is taken care of, if they have these conditions, my friend, and the thing of the matter is it's all based on convenience. See, they not just have conditions. By the way, these people, oh, my goodness, these people put, get this now, and again, it doesn't matter whether you're talking about a couple. It doesn't matter whether you're talking about a church. It doesn't matter whether you're talking about a company. It doesn't matter, my friend. These people that aren't successful, they have this if mentality, this conditional. The if stands for conditional and stands for convenience. So watch this. So in a nutshell, they put people and things on trial almost every day. So what do you mean by putting them on trial? In other words, so with these people, they have these conditions. So if the conditions are met, they fine, everything's okay. But life isn't like that, my friend. Life, like Les says, life will knock you down, man. Life will test you. Life will try you. I mean, I don't know what planet some of you folks think you're trying to get on the planet that doesn't exist. I mean, life is hard, and life is going to try you. And the Bible even says, man that is born a woman that is a few days in much trouble. So there's going to be trials. There's going to be trouble. There's going to be heartaches. There's going to be misunderstandings. There's going to be setbacks. But like Willie Jolly says, a setback is a setup for comeback. And Dr. Breakthrough says setbacks pave the way for comebacks. But these folks don't believe that. This if crowd, is everything's based on conditions. Everything's based on convenience. And they always put folks on trial. So in other words, if you do be right today and you are operating above par and you do exactly meet all my conditions today and make everything convenient for me, we fine. But watch this. But if you ever don't meet my conditions, here's what it means by on trial. In other words, they're always seeking new evidence. And the thing of the matter is, and here's why these people usually aren't successful, they're always seeking negative evidence. You ever heard somebody, like something happens, they're like, I knew it was going to happen. I knew that bad thing was going to happen. Now, they never say when something good happens, ooh, I knew that was going to happen. I mean, they're shocked, right? These, the if crowd that's not usually successful, this if crowd, they got these conditions, this if crowd, they do things based on convenience, the if crowd, they always have something on trial, and you could do 10,000 things right, that doesn't matter to them. When you do one thing wrong, they got you on trial now. That one thing now, all of a sudden, they got a bad impression of you now. That one thing now, well, they don't want to do the business now. That one bad thing, they always put things on trial. And folks, they can't understand why they're not successful. And I'll tell you why. Because, my friend, they can't even keep up on their own. They haven't even reached their own perfectionistic level almost that they put on things, but they got all these conditions, and everything's got to be convenient for them. And if they are ever inconvenienced, oh, they're out of here, man. Oh, no. You know, I don't know who y'all think y'all are, man. So, Coach is the greatest guy in the world today, and then tomorrow, I don't know, because they got him on trial, right? They got them on trials, like they got to keep. And the crazy thing is, they're looking for negative evidence. Hey, I always say there's so much good in the worst of us, and so much bad in the best of us that it hardly behooves any of us to talk about the rest of us, right? And again, my friend, so the deal is, it's are you one of these if? Are you around a lot of people with this if mentality, right? And again, they got all these conditions, and it's got to be convenient for them, right? And they're going to put you on trial. It's like, okay, well, you treated me nice, you know, all year, but today you let me down. And so what you're going to do now is you're going to zero in on the fact that today you let them down. And by the way, welcome to life. I got news for you. Everybody in the world going to let you down. Matter of fact, if you ever wake up, you'll realize you let you down. Come on, somebody. That's the hardest thing I have to deal with, right? When you let yourself down. But again, you got to realize sometimes that's part of life, my friend. But you can't, I mean, you can be an if person if you want to, but just know one thing, you can't be an if person to be super successful. You can be an if person if you want to, but if you're going to be an if person, you're not going to be successful. You can be an if person if you want to, but if you are, just recognize one thing, my friend, you will rarely ever succeed if you ever do. Why? Because of the if. You've got a condition because of the if. You're all about convenience. And that, you know, years ago, people used to say, take it easy, take it easy. I'm like, don't tell me to take it easy. I didn't become a 10th degree black belt by taking it easy. I didn't get voted into the Black Belt Hall of Fame by taking it easy. Listen, my friend, taking it easy? No. I just tell folks, I want to take it rough. Why? It's good for a man, the Bible says, to bear the yoke in his youth. See, here's what I found out, my friend. It was like what Mike Tyson said. So everybody got a plan until they get punched in the face. And so here's what Rocky told his son. It's not how hard you can hit. It's how hard you can get hit, get knocked down, but get back up. That's going to determine how you're successful. But this if crowd gets knocked out. Again, they always got things on trial, and they're looking for negative evidence all the time. And because of the negative emotion, watch this now, and really they have negative belief towards something. I mean, they're in, but, you know, by fire, right? Just by the skin of their teeth, old folks used to say, right? And so I'm telling you, my friend, we got so many folks, and they're just on the fringes. As a matter of fact, I was listening to a powerful little 8-minute piece by Bishop T.D. Jakes, and he said you got some followers who are distant followers. And I was like, wow, that would fit this if crowd, right? The distant followers. They, you know, they're following, but they like way far off, right? So number one, the if crowd. Then you got the because crowd, the because, okay? Now, the if crowd, as I mentioned, it's all based on what? It's based on conditions. It's based on what? Convenience. But then the because crowd, it's based on a cause, or it's based on a care, right? Because they care about something, then they'll do something because of that, right? Or it's based on a connection, right? So I mean, now these people can have success, right? Because they care. They have success. And you've heard it said, people don't care how much you know until they know how much you care. Well, the because crowd, they do what they do because they care. And when you care, watch this now, when you care, people respond. When you care, you're going to share. And when you share out of care, you're going to bear some fruit. Ooh, that's good. I'm a poet and don't know it. Somebody call Dr. Ty Grail. Tell him I'm coming up on him. But watch this, my friend. I'm saying we got too many folks. They're frustrated. Why aren't I successful? Because you got if. You got the conditions. You all about convenience. And you always putting things on trial and looking for negative evidence all the time. But the because crowd, no, they said, no, I care. The because crowd, they have success because they care. The because crowd, they have success. Why? Because they have they build a connection. See, because I'm connected, I'm going to do this company because I'm connected to Coach. I'm going to do this business because I'm connected to Liddy. I'm doing this because I'm connected to Shante, because I'm connected to Bernard Mallory, because I'm connected to Apostle Barry. Because, I mean, that because crowd, and watch this, my friend, and they will do, I mean, they get some success, my friend. Why? Because they care. They get success because they got a connection, and they're doing what they do. No, not with the conditional mentality like the folks who don't make the success. No, they don't put you on trial every day. But I tell you what, my friend, they are so into doing things because. And so because Bishop Neal is part of the deal, I'm going to join, right? It's always because Lester Carter is part of the deal, I'm going to be part of this. Because Sister Shirley, because Coach, you know, Ken, because, okay, and they always do things because. So, again, the because, my friend, and again, not, and please don't, I'm not getting on anybody. I'm just, you ought to be able to tell where you are, and as a leader, you're going to be able to tell where people are and help them to go to the next level if they choose to. See, the folks who aren't successful are doing things if, and if they want to be successful, they got to learn to jump up a notch to start doing things because. But watch, oh, by the way, the if crowd, by the way, it was George Washington Carver who said it best. He said, if you want something bad enough, you'll find a way, and if not, any old excuse will do. Well, the if crowd always seems to find excuses. Matter of fact, they'll manufacture some if they have to, right? But the condition's not going to be right. It's not going to be convenient. But this because crowd, they have care. This because crowd, they're connected. And they do what they do because they're connected. They do what they do because they care. They do what they do because there's a cause, and they become part of the cause. And man, they're okay. So I'm going to do that. I'm with you. And so it's there's nothing more wonderful to have somebody who cares, and they care enough to share with you, right? And I was thinking about this powerful woman who's part of our team now, Sharon, but one of her friends who's also part of the team, Beverly. We were in another business, and I was speaking there in Michigan for them, and so Beverly was talking about, you know, Sharon, I was just so scared. Sharon said to Beverly. Why didn't you share this with me sooner? Because when she found out how long we've been doing it, she said, why didn't you tell me sooner? And Beverly said, well, I was afraid because you're such a powerful woman. She's like, girl, listen, you have told me sooner. I could have got a quicker jump, right? And but at any rate, but again, my friend, there are people that they have a connection because they care, because they'll get involved. And these people are successful. These people produce success. What, mark it down, whenever somebody cares. See, there's some people in the world, all they need to know is that somebody cares. You know, every time we go down, I'm about an hour north of Dallas, you know, downtown Dallas. When we drive down to Dallas and meet with somebody, whatever else, we always pass that huge, huge building as we go down the Dallas North Tollway. Of course, it's called the North Tollway, but you can go south. That always got me twisted the first time I got here. But anyway, this huge, beautiful, magnificent building, the Mary Kay Foundation, Mary Kay built. I mean, multi-billion-dollar business this woman built. And one of her principles was, you know, act like people got a sign around the neck saying, you know, treat me as if I'm somebody. Show me you care, right? That was part of the success to her training those ladies. And when you do it, when you have a business, I'm part of this church because, right? You got a cause, you care. There's a connection. But the super successful. So here's where in case anybody's interested in being super. I mean, if you may or may not succeed, and you probably won't, because, well, you're going to have some success. But this last one, in spite of, now, here is where the super successful hang out. Here is where the super successful dwell. And I've told you this many, many times. I have never been a network marketer, nor will I ever be. I've always been a networker who leverages marketing. But one of the problems I see with network marketers is they try to get people to do things. But a networker who leverages marketing, we work on getting people to believe things. Because, see, if people believe things, they automatically do some things. So watch this now. So the in spite of crowd, the ones who are super successful, they're marked by commitment. Write that down. They are marked by commitment. See, if crowd has no commitment, they got conditions. If crowd is no commitment here, I'm committed to my own convenience, and as long as y'all do everything just right, the way I like it, the way I – then we fine, and I'll be around. But if not, I'm out of here. You know, and they're always looking for ways to get out of here. So, but again, it's okay. You've got to have some folk like that around. So it's okay. Don't. You know, just let them be. Let them do the thing. I mean, it's okay. You know, they'll make an order once or twice, and then all of a sudden, you know, as long as the company sends the product, like a guy the other day said, wait a minute, it looks like. I mean, I just ordered the other day. How'd these products get here so fast, right? But as soon as somebody does, you know, the order doesn't come right, or maybe it takes a little longer, it's like, hey, what happened? What's going on? That's that if crowd. But the because crowd, you know, they're a little fine. But this in spite of crowd, they're like, look, the sun rises, the east sets in the west, the Pope's a Catholic, and I'm here, right? I made a commitment. See, I made a commitment. People are like, well, we're going to have a call today. It's Memorial Day. Okay, what does that mean? Of course we're going to have a call. We made a commitment, right? If it's two people, we'll have a call. Why? Because because this in spite of crowd, they don't understand. See, they don't understand conditions. The in spite of crowd, they don't understand doing something just because you're connected to somebody, just because you care. No, the in spite of crowd says, if I care, if I don't care, if I feel good, if I don't feel good, don't matter, I'm doing this thing. The in spite of crowd is a crowd that says, you know what, like when I was working out in the martial arts and I broke my elbow, got my elbow broken in a tournament. I was just a young teenager, 16, and I was a brown belt at the time. And this guy, it was a televised tournament. And this guy, well, actually, no, I was 15. I take it back. So back then they had a junior division where they took the teenagers 13 to 17. And so this guy was a televised tournament, and he was a black belt. He was like 24, but he was short, so he had a young looking face. And so he snuck into the junior division because, again, it was televised and there was cash prizes and everything. And so he figured, you know, he could win easily in that division, right? And by the way, he almost, until they finally figured out, you know, they disqualified him after the fact. But in the meantime, he fought one of my friends, my best friend, Willie Lewis, back then. I'll never forget, knocked Willie out. And of course, it's supposed to be light contact. He should have got disqualified, but they didn't. They still let him go. And then next thing I know, I was up against fighting with him, and it was incredible. My mom was there. So, you know, I had to, I mean, brother man's going to do what he does. But when mom shows up, and now wife shows up, watch out now. Y'all better watch it. Your daughter shows up, ooh, I'm in extra hyper gear. But anyway, and so we're fighting, and this guy kicked me. I mean, he kicked so hard, and I went to block, and it was like, oh, my goodness, my elbow was hurting. And he kicked again. I went to block, and it was like my arm locked. Like it just went down straight. It was locked. And so the judge like, okay, you want to stop fighting? I'm like, I looked at my mom. I'm at my peripheral vision. I was like, no, I'm fighting. Come on, let's go. So I'm fighting with one hand, right? And anyway, make a long story short, after the fight, which, you know, he won, I went over to my mom. I said, well, mom, she's like, son, are you doing okay? I was like, I think it might be broken. And was I ever right? And they had to reset it and put the pins in. Actually, the ball was actually broken in two places. And anyway, they found out later on the guy was, you know, kicked him out. But I said all that to say, people, and so my mom was like, are you still going to go to practice? Once I got my cast and everything, I'm like, well, yes, ma'am. So I went to practice. By the way, that's where I learned how to do one-hand push-ups. You know why? Because when they got down to do push-ups, I only had one hand I could use. So I struggled for a while, but I got it down where I did one-hand push-ups. And every time they did a punch, I did two punches because I only had one hand. Are you listening, my friend? They did a block. I did two blocks because I only had one hand. Now I'm just saying this, my friend, and I'm not tooting my own horn, but it's a fact that I'm going to tell you about. And I'm saying this, my friend. I'm saying I didn't understand, but I was laying a foundation way back yonder that I was the kind of person that, see, if I was an if person, I'm like, I'm out of here, man. Got my arm broke. I'm out of here, right? And people in school used to say, hey, I thought you're taking this martial arts to get better. And I was like, yeah, but the other guy's better than me, right? And the because crowd, as long as it's all good and everything, and I had the connection and caring. Hey, there was one time my instructor in Japanese, you call him sensei, and the style I took was called Ishinu Karate. But he had a little get-together thing, and he was always drinking sake, Japanese wine. He got drunk. And matter of fact, I never told anybody about this. And just the other day, I was thinking about it. Sometimes you just things pop in your mind. And my sensei started beating on me, literally. I mean, he was drunk. And, you know, obviously – and he starts beating on me, man, and hit me in the head, everything. And so – and I get this incredible headache, and I'm hurting, and I'm like almost disillusioned. Like, I don't understand, why is my sensei doing this, right? And, of course, I grew up dragging my grandfather out of what they used to call the beer gardens. And so I just equated with, okay, he's full of alcohol. That's not really him, it's alcohol. But at any rate, I remember, it was very a time of, I could have been very disillusioned. But guess what? But see, nobody knew. They didn't know that I'd been jumped and tarred and feathered as a 6-year-old. They didn't know that my commitment I had in spite of. I'm going to be the best. I'm going to make sure that this doesn't happen to me anymore. And so, in spite of the fact, watch this now. In spite of the fact that my own instructor beat on me, in spite of the fact, my friend, that in his drunkenness you know, that he you know, he dishonored me, he beat on me. I mean, anybody else probably would have quit, but no, I'm like, I'm an in spite of type person. And listen, and was there anybody want to understand that by the time my sensei, which I got a chance to lead him to Christ many, many decades later, and when he was, before he passed, he said, when I pass, Dr. Breakthrough, Dr. Stan Harris will take over my whole, the whole system. He inherits my belt and everything else. I mean, but what I'm saying is this, but the thing is, because of the in spite of mentality that I had with the martial arts, it made me a super champion. And then I learned to transfer that to business. And I'm telling you, my friend, people hear about me building a team to 1.5 million where the company only had 2.2 million. But they don't know about the fact when I started the business, I was up 3 days without any sleep. Just work. My baby was like, baby, you, Lottie's like, honey, you come to bed. No, ma'am. I got facts tell, testimony sell. I got to create a testimony. And when I create that, I'm going to be able to sell it like crazy. But I'm saying I learned to do what I do in spite of, my friend. And to some of us to have this in spite of mentality. Hey, like I told my wife, baby, if you ever try to leave me, I'm leaving with you. I said, we together for life. She said, yeah, big boy, if you ever try to leave me, I'm leaving with you too. I said, okay, we leave together. See, the problem is we don't have couples these days don't have that commitment. They don't have that in spite of, you know, up, down, in. We together, we doing this thing. And when it comes to churches, people used to have a commitment to church. They don't have that anymore. Now it's like, no, this in spite of crowd, they're committed. You can bank on them, my friend. They're going to be there. Okay, the site goes down. Okay, you didn't hear the news. Okay, you're trying to sign somebody up, but in spite of people like, hey, listen, when it gets back up, we're back at it. And in the meantime, I could just write down your information and get all the information down. And as soon as it's back up, because it will be back up, by the way, one gentleman told me, he said, well, at least y'all doing better than the city of Baltimore. The website's been down for 3 weeks. How'd you like that? What are you going to do, move out of Baltimore? Hey, what I'm saying is this. I'm saying in spite of, you got to be an in spite of type person. And that's the, if you want to know the difference between Dr. Breakthrough and just about a lot of other folk, I got an in spite of type of mentality, my friend. I do what I do in spite of it. So I don't give myself any excuses. I don't give myself any outs. And, of course, I don't give you any either. And I was thinking about today. The Bible says there's an iron sharpeneth iron, so a man sharpeneth the countenance of his friends. Sometimes when there's a sharpening, there's some sparks flying, and some folks don't like them sparks. But Jesus said, as many as I love, I rebuke and chasten. Come on, somebody. But I'm telling you, my friend, but I'm telling you, and people look at you like, oh, you're overachiever. Yeah, because I learned to develop a in spite of mentality. Again, remember I said, without a breakthrough mentality, nothing in heaven or earth can help you. With a breakthrough mentality, nothing on earth can stop you. So with an in spite of type of mentality, and I'm going to do this thing, my friend. It may not happen when I want it. It may not happen as fast, but I'm in spite of, I'm here. I'm committed, and I'm determined. See, nothing in the world can take the place of persistence. Talent will not. Nothing is more common than unsuccessful men with talent. Genius will not. Unrewarded genius is almost a proverb. Education will not. The world is full of educated derelicts. Persistence and determination alone are almost omnipotent, by Calvin Coolidge. And that in spite of crowd, they just won't give up. That in spite of crowd, matter of fact, the in spite of crowd, watch this now, they are looking, you know, the if crowd is looking for faults. The in spite of crowd is always looking for the good points. You know, something good happens. I knew it was going to happen. Something bad happens. Oh, I'm shocked. But guess what? I'm still in here. Something good happens. I knew that was going to happen. But the if crowd, no, something bad happens. I knew that was going to happen. Something good happens. They're shocked. No. Just wait. So, again, you decide. And what kind of team you want to build. See, you got to learn to find some in spite of folk, right? See, you can't build a team with all these if folk. If it's this, if it's that. And sometimes, especially with Shop Free Mart, one of the greatest problems I see is folks can join for free. So guess what? There's no commitment. So watch this. People pay no attention to what they pay nothing for. They pay little attention to what they pay little for. They pay much attention to what they pay much for. And so again, my friend, here in this community, shark, my friend, we ain't going to be tacking everybody with, see, we're going to teach you about shark bait. You don't catch sharks with free, my friend. No. You got to come with a freedom pack. You got to come with that freedom pack and the V card. Make $108 per sale. They're like, well, sharks are like, whoa, what? Oh, yeah. See, but here's what I'm saying, my friend. I'm telling you this. This will make a difference in your spiritual life. It'll make a difference in your relationships. It'll make a difference, my friend, in your business. It'll make a difference in your workout. See, some folk work out if, some work out because, but the real ones are the ones who work out in spite of, right? Just in spite of, man, I'm going to be there. And so I got to go. Time is out. Y'all got to go. You got to enjoy your Memorial Day. But that's what differentiates Memorial Day. You got some folk that said, you know, if everything's right, I'll fight. I'll stand for the country. And other folks say, no, I'm doing it because. But the folk that lose their lives are the ones I'm in spite of. I'm here, man. I'm here. Okay, look like the enemy's coming. We might end up losing. Okay, well, we're going to hold this fort as long as we can. And they finally going to get me. They're going to get me. But they're going to get me while I'm swinging like the lady back in Civil War days. She had a broom, and she's swinging. They're like, you ain't doing much with a broom. She said, oh, yeah, I do a little something. But I tell you one thing, I'm going down with a fight. And if all I got is a broom, I'm swinging it, my friend. That in spite of mentality. Coach, give me some in spite of sharks in this team. Give me some in spite of folks. You know, we ain't got to check and see if there's a call. I'm dialing in regardless. Matter of fact, if I dial in and the call's not on, I'm shocked, right? But in spite of, that's how you build big teams. That's how you build successful marriages. That's how you raise successful children. That's how you raise and have a big, successful business. That's how you have a successful spiritual life, my friend. I teach people, pray when you feel like it. Pray when you don't feel like it. Just pray until you do feel like it. Come on now. Read the Bible when you feel like it. Read the Bible when you don't feel like it. Just read the Bible till you do feel like it. Work out, my friend, when you feel like it. Work out when you don't feel like it. Work out till you do feel like it. I'm telling you, my friend, the in spite of crowd, that's the super successful. The in spite of crowd, that's the one that people say, well, I wish I was like so-and-so. No, you know, no, it's not the personality. It's not the looks. It's not all the other outside stuff you see. It's the inside belief system. It's this mentality of I'm going to do what I do in spite of, my friend. And when you have that kind of mentality, when you have that kind of belief system, my friend, the world begins to open up to you. No, it doesn't open up overnight. But the in spite of crowd says, look, I thought I was going to be able to have it done in a month. Okay, it'll take me 2 months. It don't matter. In spite of, I'm going to make it, my friend. Okay, if it takes me 3 months, I don't care. In spite of, if it takes me 10 years, it doesn't matter. I'm in for the long haul. So, my friend, I'm telling you, you decide. You're going to be part of the if crowd, the because crowd, or the in spite of crowd. Well, you actually don't have to tell us because your results will tell us. Jesus told us by the fruits. And so I'll close with Bishop Jakes. Like I said, he mentioned just yesterday, I was hearing a thing, and he mentioned about, and of course, I'd already had this talk planned, but he had the thing about people that follow, distant followers, he said. And then he said designated followers. And then he said divine. Oh, no, distant supporters, designated supporters, and divine supporters. And I would have likened those divine supporters to the in spite of crowd and the designated to the because crowd and the distant to the if crowd, right? And Jesus, when he preached the hard sermon, it said many turned around and walked no more, and he looked at his disciples. He said, will you also go away? I feel like that sometimes. They said, this is a hard saying. Who can hear it? And the Bible says many left. But then Jesus turned to the 12. He said, well, you also, y'all going to leave me too? And I tell you what, my friend, in spite of crowd, you find you a couple of those, you in like Flint. Hey, God bless you. It's breakthrough time. Shark, shark. Back to Kenny. I'm way over again.
Shark, shark. Hey, thank you for speaking to the in spite of crowd. I'm telling you right now. Lord, just find some more in spite of people, and you're on your way. Because in spite of people, all I like about them is they work the business in spite of you. So you can say, I quit. You can say, I quit. They say, well, okay, bye. They keep on working. So thank God for the in spite of. Hey, incredible teaching today. If, because, and in spite of. Hey, guys, go out and make it an incredible day. Happy Memorial Day. Go out there and chew on some food, but be chewing on some prospects. Just always be chewing. That breakthrough that I was here at the top. Shop, shop. But you got breakthrough.
All righty. God bless you.